his job is based out of Washington, and my job is based out of Georgia, where we're from.
And then when we got married, she was like, I'm not doing that.
I use the IV warmers, and that heats our water.
It was a lot more in our price range and in our budget.
Hello, this is Seth and Christy. That behind us is Mitty the Ambulance, so come take a tour.
So this is our kitchen area. This layout was roughly already here with the ambulance, which was helpful and very complicated at the same time. It came out great and we're really happy with it, but it did take quite a bit of engineering, I would say. This is our pantry in here. It has a little Lazy Susan in here, which is helpful because it's super deep. The other thing that's really great about the ambulance and why we kept the cabinets is they all open this way as well. We feel bougie because we have a laundry chute right here, and then that opens from outside and we can grab it and take it to the laundromat. Here we have all of our silverware, cutlery, knives, everything that we could need. So our fridge is a truck fridge, which is helpful because it's designed to be in trucks in moving vehicles. So that is beneficial because there's a lot of rattling and shaking and stuff that goes on, and this is more equipped to handle it than if we had just bought your basic mini fridge. And it is 12 volt as well, so it's more efficient on power. So right here used to be a slide out drawer, and instead we cut into the countertop and dropped the sink in, but we didn't want to waste the space. You can never waste space. So this is where our toothbrush is and all that kind of stuff. This cutout used to be the aspirator. Had to make it bigger obviously, but this is where we have 7 gallon gray water under here. So this oven has worked really great for us, but we had to find one that was like the exact dimensions to fit into the area. And then we had like 3 or 4 inches on either side. And again, can't waste any space. So Seth made a little spice rack here. Another unique thing about our counter is that this comes up, and this is what I use as a desk during the day. We have Lagoon table mounts, which we love. Seth came up with kind of running tracks that we slide the mount onto, and then we can set it up, and then we don't have an awkward piece of wood. This shelving was already here. We just added the doors when we put the whole face of the kitchen on. And then that is all of our dishware, pots and pans and everything in there. There's a lot of stickers going on in here. This is contact paper sticker. These tiles are just stick-on, and they've actually stayed on really well. The countertop is butcher block that we stained. The sink is hand-hammered copper. We have the faucet, which is awesome because it stretches and moves everywhere. We also say that we're fancy because we can use it as like a pot filler over the stove, you know? This is the like electrical components a little bit for it. We did not relabel things, so it still says aspirator, but that is our water pump. Up here, have some spices, paper towels, a little bit of a bar section, kind of. I've got my wine glasses, which are plastic, and then we've got like a shaker, stuff like that. We keep, this is his work setup, his monitor and stuff, my Lagoon table mount, and just whatever else. So in this big old cabinet, we have all of our like electrical stuff, our laptops. I call this my craft box. This is like home stuff, tape, whatever. And then we have like a little like first aid medicine stuff up here. And then on this side, Seth installed this window unit, which was really helpful. He's got it insulated back there. He's got a painter's pan here to catch the condensation. The other thing is that it needed to vent. It needed to get all that air out. We needed fresh air in, we need hot air out. So the ambulance had a fan already over there. Seth took it out of there and put it in the back of here. And so now we can turn a fan on and off, and that'll help draw the hot air away from the window unit. We didn't want to lose our like stealth look with having more vents outside though. So one of the ambulance lights that we aren't using, Seth spray painted it and then cut a little section out of it, covered it in a screen, and so that is a secret vent. We have used it a few times. It takes a good bit of power, but it's really come in handy when you're trying to sleep and you're sweating. We have these hooks in here, which is super helpful when you're coming in. Jackets and everything can just dry right here, which is really nice. In here, This is kind of like a catch-all area a little bit. This area also opens to the outside. And so a lot of what is in here is stuff that we would use outside. So like we have our camping chairs, we have Seth's hammock, we have little outdoor tables, stuff like that, that we would want to grab from the outside. And then also, since we weren't able to put the larger fridge in that we wanted in the kitchen area, we needed more space. And so we were able to install this fridge. It can be used as a fridge or a freezer. We keep it as a freezer, and we keep drinks and stuff in here. And the cool thing about this is that, since again this is a door, there are additional slides that would allow it to slide outside. So if you are out there and you want a drink or something, you just slide the fridge out, grab whatever you need, and slide it back in. Seth and I both work full-time. His job is based out of Washington, and my job is based out of Georgia, where we're from. So we had to be able to keep up with all of them. It gets really confusing when we're trying to make plans and he's on Pacific time and I'm on Eastern time for our jobs, but then we also happen to be in mountain time for our location and things get really wild. So this is super helpful to just be like, what time is it and where are we?
So something that drew us to, you know, living in an ambulance, I've always wanted to live in my 4Runner. So I was building it out while I was dating Christy, and she was like, oh, that's cool. And then when we got married, she was like, I'm not doing that. but then we ended up looking into like vans and everything, and she let me know one Christmas that she was game. She gave me a gift, so we started saving up. And the big thing that actually like moved us into the ambulance was we wanted to have a change. You know, we had friends that they were having babies and we didn't want to have babies right now, and we wanted to do something different and kind of shock our system from the norm. We had a nice house, we had good jobs, but we wanted to shake things up a little bit and venture out into the world and see what it had to offer.
Even though we're staying in the continental United States, there's just so much to see and mm-hmm. do and experience here. There's so much different scenery and landscaping and people to meet. We have not experienced that in our tiny little corner in Georgia where we were, you know, like we wanted to be more well-rounded people and, you know, have this life experience to kind of help shape our worldview a little bit more.
Yeah.
So this is our electrical system. This cabinet was already existing with the ambulance, and it actually had most of the wiring that you can see here. Part of the reason why we went with the ambulance is because we wanted to repurpose a lot of the wiring, all the fuses, all the relays and everything. So basically what I did here is I ripped out everything that we didn't need. So the sirens, everything like that, and then transitioned the door locks, all that stuff downwards. I reached out to Braun, which is the company that made this, which we really wanted a Braun ambulance, and they gave me the schematic. So this is like a large schematic of all the electrical in here. And I also downloaded it to my iPad, which has been very helpful to go through and understand what was happening in here. So basically moved all that down, added some Victron components. That's our solar charge controller, DC to DC charger. This one's a 30 amp. And then I added another 18 amp around back, so you can't see that there, but they're on two separate switches so we can charge if we're not getting enough solar. And then, so the rest of the electrical is actually down here. So all the electrical is flowing down here into our Victron Lynx distributor. And then we have our two SOK 206 amp hour batteries, making it 412 amp hours. We have found that this setup is actually very good for us and what we need. Between the DC to DC charger, and then we have 700 watts of solar. As long as we're either moving or in the sun, it keeps us pretty charged. I think in a perfect world, of course, you would probably want more batteries, maybe like 600 amp hours. I might add another one in the future, but so far we've been on the road for a little over 7 months, I believe, and it's worked out great for us. And the last thing for the electrical is our Jackery. We do have a 1,000 watt inverter. Just being on, it uses around 30 watts. So we got this little 300 watt hour Jackery that actually has been ideal for the situation. We plug all of our stuff to charge our phones, our Apple Watches, headphones, and we just run it off of this. And then I have a little 12 volt cigarette lighter under here that I use to charge it. And so we don't have any loss to charge it. So it all goes through here. So we actually use this every day. And then this is our Victron battery monitor. So this is the way that we monitor the whole system. So anything that's pretty much going through the ambulance to run this back end, we can monitor through here. So this is our bed slash couch slash office space slash just about anything else, like dining room, I guess. So Christy wanted a bed that we did not have to make, but also did not want a fixed bed. And then also wanted to have at least like a queen size bed. I liked the puzzle that I had to figure out. So basically I have three sheets of wood, one that you sit on, a backrest, and then there's another one that folds in the back. And we put it on two 500 pound drawer slides. So basically we unlock those, slide it out, and it will slide out into a queen size width. The length of it is around 6 feet. So it's a little bit shorter than a normal queen, but we're both pretty short. So it works out for us. It is on a 3-inch foam mattress that we had before. Ideally, we would probably do a 4-inch, but it's worked pretty great for us so far. And during the day, we have it like this. That is my workspace. I have my laptop there, and then I have a monitor stand. So I have two screens, and then Christy has the table over here that's above the stove, and that's her desk for the day. This is some storage up here. We call this our side tables. So just like you have side tables normally at your house, this is Christy's, this is mine. We access those pretty much every day. And then some more storage over here. This is like our bathroom items, mostly Christy's stuff. And then under here, we do have some reading lamps. These are actually really solid. I debated doing these very last minute, and we did them, and we use them just about every day. They're just from Amazon, but they dim. It's really nice because we do have three, I guess, sections of lights. We have the overhead, we have the strips, and then we have the kitchen area. But if we want it to be like extremely dim, what we'll do is actually turn on one or two of these and then put it all the way low. And it's just enough light to see around, but it doesn't get in the way.
Okay, so this is our shower bathroom. When we were building this out, we weren't super sure if we want a shower. We thought we would really want one, but a lot of videos we saw, people that had them said they didn't really use them, or if they didn't have them, they said they didn't miss it. We cannot relate to those people because we use this almost every day and we are really grateful that we have it. So underneath the platform of the shower, we have a 5-gallon gray water, and we have a secret hidden button in here that allows us to open and close the gray water so that we can have it drain or we can have it stay in there, whatever we need. The toilet is a cassette toilet, so when we shower, we just take it right out of the way and set it aside. The mat that's on the floor of the shower is a teak mat that we just got and made it work for our space. So the idea is that since this is a door and opens to the outside, we can take the shower head off, rinse off out there. We can put the teak mat on the ground and keep our feet nice and clean, and then be able to hose off if we're muddy or gross. Normally it's the dog that's muddy and gross. So that's really helpful to have, and why we went with the shower that we did. So what we do is we have the shower curtain here, and we have these hooks, and we just run the shower curtain across, and then you have plenty of space for your arms and do all the washing that you need to do. So this cabinet is all of our clothes, and definitely recommend bins. I love bins, and we actually have a ton of clothes. We haven't really even like needed as much as we have. So, and then these pull out pretty far, and then there's actually four small ones up here. So his side, my side, pretty evenly matched in the clothing amount. So then in here we have more bins, and then this has just been great because these are really big, really deep. So this is all of our like tall toiletries and stuff. So definitely recommend bins and storage. We have some bins that are under the bed, and they're in like wooden crates. And so what we did was we put a magnet strip on the back and then put a magnet strip on the wall. And that's super helpful to make sure they don't slide or whatever. And you just give it a tug, pull your shoes out or whatever's in there, and then push it right back under the bed. So this my sister got as a Christmas gift to us like 2 years ago when we were building this out. So that was a really nice addition and like one of the first decor pieces we put up in here. So when we were first putting in all these like decor pieces, my dad got really concerned that we were gonna have projectiles flying around the ambulance. I told him, Dad, if these are flying around, we have bigger problems. But a helpful hack is that we have all of this Velcroed on so that they're not going to become projectiles flying around. So everything in here is stuck right in place, and we've never had an issue with that falling off. So it's been really great. There's so much that you can gain from this life. I think it outweighs what you would be giving up. And so thinking about that mindset of, you know, the excitement of exploring and traveling and hiking and camping, and also just the freedom of it and being able to do and see what we want to. And then I think also for me, I'm a money person. And so once we were able to work out the finances of, okay, how can we make this work, you know? And that's another reason it led us to an ambulance. It was a lot more in our price range and in our budget than some of the fancier vans. So once all those pieces fell into place, it was kind of like, you know what, it's not really a good reason not to.
Yeah, so the ambulance, Christy actually found it on Facebook Marketplace. We bought it for $7,000. And then the full build out after that was an additional around $12,000-$13,000. And then we actually spent around $8,000 to get some work done that we wanted to make sure that we were ready for the road. So glow plugs, injectors, a lot of that work. So total cost to get us on the road was around $30,000-$35,000.
So if we look at our how much we spent on the build and how much we spent about a year living in our house, it's kind of close to equal. But if you were to say we're staying in our house and now we're flying to do all these trips and we're trying to travel and stay in places and hotels and whatever, we're saving a crazy amount of money. That being said, we are spending about a mortgage in diesel each month. But luckily, since we both work full time, we've been able to cover that cost. But I would say, since we aren't budgeting, we're not being terribly careful on the road, we're probably coming about even as when we lived in our house.
Just to add on that, mm-hmm. I think that it depends on how fast you're going too, because our biggest expense is diesel, mm-hmm. and we get around 10 miles to the gallon on a good day. So our first 6 months, we definitely spent way more than our mortgage on diesel. And now we're spending a little less. So I think that fluctuates, but in regards to like the recurring payments of like, you know, insurance, all that kind of stuff, it's been, I think, cheaper. Mm-hmm. So this is some outside storage. These are a lot of the things that we use if we're going camping. We'll pull out our chairs, some tables. This is our fridge. So this fridge, it's a fridge freezer. We use it as a freezer right now. It pulls out. And you can open it that way. And I'm sure Christy mentioned you can open it the other way also. So this is our shower. So it opens this way as well. And then below that is our plumbing. So a little 5 gallon gray water tank. And then this is for our diesel heater. This is a little 2 gallon tank. And then I have another tank on the other end that we last about a week whenever the diesel heater is running. So this is our garage. So the top half right here, this you can access from outside and inside. And then below it is all the garage stuff. So all the tools up top and below. And then on the wall here, we have the ladder to get up on the roof, and then just some extra components just in case we need them. This is our water compartment. So we have a 40 gallon fresh water tank. We have the water fixer filtration system. So that's like a 5 micron pleated filter, a 0.5 micron carbon filter, and then a UV light. So we can pull water from a stream, they say, and it's totally fine. We've tested it pretty much once to see if it worked. And then actually a fun fact. So I used the IV warmers that were a part of the ambulance. And that heats our water. So to make sure in the cold weather that our water stays warm. So that's underneath one of the compartments in there. This is the last compartment. Basically what we have is a 2.5 gallon water tank. It's made for like residential 120, but I put a 12 volt heating element in there. And then a 20 pound propane tank. Something that was kind of difficult was running the water back to the shower. You don't really think about it, but ran the water all the way up in there behind a wall, down the back, and then down into the shower. So this is just some valves for the water to turn it on and off. So this is the front. This is a Ford E450, a 2001. It's a 7.3 diesel. Up top there, we got our light bar attached to a little carrying rack. Up top, we have the solar, so that's the 700 watts. So I just mounted those together and strapped them up top using 80/20 and then built the whole little rack system for it to all mount to.
Thanks guys for following our tour and meeting Mitty the Ambo. If you want to keep up with our travels, we have an Instagram called Mitty the Ambo. We also do have like so many hours of recordings of us building it that we hope to put on a YouTube channel at some point. So we'll probably link that in our Instagram whenever we get there. So if you are looking for that too, then definitely follow the Instagram for future announcements in that area.
Yeah, and thanks for coming to see everything, viewing everything, and hope to see you on the road.